Hey, welcome back to Diode Press. I'm Graham. Today, we're going to be playing with lasers. I was contacted by Xtool to see if I wanted to use and review one of their D1 Pro 20-watt lasers. I recently watched a video on Peter Brown's channel all about this laser, and it looked amazing. So of course, I immediately said yes. I've been wanting a laser in my studio ever since I had one in a shared space a few years ago, and I loved all the possibilities that having a laser can provide. Being transparent with you all is really important to me, so Xtool is not paying me for this video or my opinions about it, but they did provide me with the laser and the accessories. I'd be happy to answer any questions about my experience using the laser or projects you'd like to see me do in future videos. And if you want to check them out for yourself, I'll put some links down in the description box. There's a lot of unboxing videos and full walkthroughs on YouTube about this laser, so I'll keep mine brief, but I was really impressed with the packaging and the small number of total pieces that the laser is made up of. I've put together my share of 3D printer kits and other tools, and this was basically a few steps from start to finish. There was only two places that slowed me down a bit. First was plugging in the cables into the control board. It's a really small area to get them plugged into, but as long as you line them up the right way and take your time, it was fine. Second was when connecting the laser gantry to the main frame. The manual shows using long screws to connect it, however, they interfered with the screws that hold on the motor. But they did provide shorter screws, which worked perfect, so I assume it's probably just an update somewhere in the online documentation that's not in the manual. Everything else went together with no issues at all. In addition to the laser, I received the air assist kit, an enclosure, and the honeycomb plate. These are all extra from the base laser, but I think the air assist is a must-have. It makes a much cleaner cut and was really simple to hook up. The honeycomb plate is really convenient and gives you a big work surface to cut on. You do lose some of the clearance for thicker materials, but we'll address that later in the video. Finally, we have the enclosure. Having run a laser in the past, I think this is a must-have as well. It has a small computer fan that exhausts out the fumes from the back, and it does a really good job keeping your workspace smoke and fume free. And there's a lot of smoke when you're cutting wood and other materials. The enclosure feels really sturdy, and the hard side panels basically Velcro together. I also like the safety of having the laser beam kind of fully enclosed and the viewing area made out of a, laser-safe plastic. Even if you're wearing the goggles they provide, other folks coming into your workshop might not be, and I just don't like the thought of that, so I recommend the enclosure. And finally, the kit came with a small assortment of supplies, which are great to get a feel for kind of what you can use this laser for, and get a sample of different projects. I've made probably about 10 projects so far, from woodblock prints to print on the press to small keychains. So make sure to subscribe to the channel so you can check out those projects soon. But let's jump into making a shop sign. Obviously, you can make this with a number of tools, from hand tools, a scroll saw, or a CNC, but of course, this video is all about lasers. I imported and scaled my logo into the software and cut it at a 1/4 inch plywood. I also cut a flat panel the same size to act as a backing. After sanding the pieces, I painted the back panel blue and the letters and logo white. Then it's just a matter of gluing the logo and then the letters down. Now the nice part about using a laser to cut out the letters is you're left with a perfect template to use to arrange the letters where they're supposed to go. The kerf, or thickness of the laser beam, provides just enough room to remove these panels after gluing down all the letters. And there it is, a shop sign. Before my next project, I made a few improvements to the laser setup. The YouTube channel The Clack Shack has a ton of useful videos about this and other laser cutters. He also sells jigs and accessory files over on Etsy. So I bought his universal jig kit, which will make future projects where I have to make multiples really easy to align. I also bought his files for the honeycomb mount for the D1 Pro. So make sure to check out his channel. The issue with the honeycomb is it's not fixed in one place relative to the machine. So this kit allows you to both secure the honeycomb to a fixed location relative to the machine, as well as raise the laser up to regain your maximum material height that you lose when you're using the honeycomb. The universal jig basically makes a zipper-looking rail along the top edge, and then your jig panels can clip in, allowing you to repeat cuts or engrave in the same spot, without needing to adjust any settings since the last time you used a particular jig. Next up, I tested out engraving on one of the metal business cards they provided with the kit. It basically burns off a paint layer, revealing your image. I don't know how durable this will be in the long run, but it's really a cool option to try out. Finally, we come to the most important project around here. My 2-year-old asked for a purple crocodile for her wall. So of course, that jumped the line from all the other projects I was currently working on. I started by cutting a 2x4 sheet of plywood into 16-inch squares to easily fit inside the machine. I purchased the SVG file of the artwork for a few dollars on Etsy after much debate with the small person commissioning this piece. I wanted the crocodile to be as large as possible, and I also didn't want to deal with seams in it. So I broke it up into 3 pieces with the intention of hanging them with gaps shown. Next up was to paint them the required purple color. Thankfully, this can of paint was left over from a wall we already painted. A few coats on the edge. And then rolling out this absolutely true-to-life crocodile color, and we're all set to hang him up. And here's the final piece.
Thanks for watching. To keep up with the videos when they're posted, make sure to subscribe to the channel. And if you want to help support this channel, you can check out the Diode Press Patreon page, where I post behind-the-scenes photos, as well as other patron rewards. Thanks!